Hey, this is Brad, and this is... Hi. The 20th time I'm trying this. Hey, this is Brad from California Custom Vans, and today we're going to take a look around our first complete build of the 2022 season. It's a 144-inch wheelbase, 4x4 Mercedes Benz Sprinter. So take a look around. Greeting you when you first open the van is our main control panel housing our passenger side bench. First, we've got our on-off function for our inverter charger, the readout for our battery monitor, the dimmer and on-off for our main LEDs in the ceiling, as well as all the controls for our rear stereo. On the floors, we've got luxury vinyl plank flooring made of all recyclable material, as well as some stainless steel trim that should keep these floors looking good for years to come. As we climb into the front of the van, you're going to find our first seating area. The driver and passenger seats both swivel, as well as the table, making this ideal for a little bit of work, eating together, or additional prep space for when you're cooking. As we move into the kitchen, you can see that I've swiveled the table out of the way of the chairs and raised it up a little bit to give us a little prep space for cooking. Here we've got a single burner true induction cooktop, super efficient for those cloudy days when your solar panels really just aren't giving you a lot of charge, or you don't have shore power charging available, or you don't plan on driving very far to get that inverter charging your battery bank. So that's super handy. Over here, we've got a stainless steel undermounted sink with a luxury faucet. We've got about 20 inches of extension, which is super handy around the van. And then behind that, we've got a dual T-vent window from C.R. Lawrence. Both sides flap open, which is great for ventilating your cooktop or just getting some fresh air circulating in your van. Here's just a little more detailed view of the undermounted sink. Undermounting sinks is probably one of my favorite things to do in a van. I think it just adds a really nice touch to the whole aesthetic, as well as shows off the end grain of this really wonderful walnut butcher block countertop, and just really sets off the sink. It makes it look luxurious. Under our cooktop, we've got this isotherm 130 drawer style refrigerator. Nice and big, plenty of room for all your supplies. Should keep you going for a couple weeks. And it looks really nice. Over here, we've got a bank of four drawers with our slam latches. Pretty deep drawers, great for utensils, towels, anything else you need in the kitchen. And they shut wonderfully. That's what we like to hear. Under our sink, we've got our 2.7-gallon hot water heater, as well as our power switches for the refrigerator, fresh water pump, and our gray water pump. The reason we include a switch for our refrigerator is for those low power situations. Maybe it's cloudy, maybe you just haven't had a chance to charge up, and really all you need is the lights and fans. You could just pop that refrigerator off and not worry about pulling a fuse or something like that. We also have an on-off for our fresh water tank, which technically can stay on all the time. The problem with that is the fresh water pump likes to self-prime, meaning it will turn on to just draw a little bit of water into itself. So the last thing you want is that going off at 2 in the morning after a long day of hiking or whatever. So we always say just pop that off. And as well as our on-off gray water tank, which is more of an on-demand system. So you just turn it on when you need it, turn it off when you don't. And that's that. As we take another look at our passenger side bench, this opens up and will soon reveal a dry flush toilet. I've done the dimensions, so it'll fit that nice and snug, as well as pre-wired it for any power consumption that that's going to need. Over here on our driver's side bench, you're going to find two AC outlets here, as well as a USB-C here and a USB 4.0, 5.0, 43.0, whatever they're on these days. And then just below that, a cigarette lighter adapter for those old school camping appliances. Underneath the bench, we've got a little bit of extra space, as well as our AC outlets for our induction cooktop, as well as our hot water heater, which do run off AC. And then this customer has asked for some pre-wiring for some future appliances. Above the kitchen, as well as the bed area, you're going to find a total of 6 overhead cabinets, nice and big for food storage or anything extra you want to put up there. We're going to open this one up and find our power switch. This is for 6 LEDs that you find run the length of the van. It really helps illuminate your cooking space if you don't want to turn on your full lights overhead. Latches are nice and snug, no rattling on those rough roads, nice and quiet ride. Gotta love that. While we're up here, we got a little sunlight shining in. We may as well talk about the ceiling. This is responsibly sourced pine tongue and groove paneling, finished off with 5 coats of water-based polyurethane, and before that, just a touch of natural stain to really bring out the grains in this wood. We finished all the top corners and bulkheads with the same tongue and groove, so you're not seeing any of the mechanics of the van. Right above me, we've got a max air fan with a fancy remote. This can pull air in or blow air out, just in case you are full of hot air.
Boo.
Sorry.
You should be.
It's also got a little temperature sensor that'll help keep your van at 78 degrees if you turn that on. We'll do some detailed shots on californiacustomvans.com so you can see the front trim and everything a little more up close and personal. Sorry about the jokes.
Don't quit your day job.
Right behind me on the back doors, you're going to find two Polk audio speakers being driven by a Kenwood Exelon amplifier that allows anything with Bluetooth to connect to it. Your phone, your iPad, your computer, and what have you. Now, while these speakers are pretty small, I've managed to house them in the topmost compartment of this door, put a little sound deadening behind it, and what that does is basically makes a little subwoofer box. Adds a lot of bass to these tiny little speakers and really fills up the van with a nice, warm, heavy sound. Underneath the bed, you're going to find a bank of 8 drawers, each set with its own specific functionality. Now, on the driver and passenger side, you're going to find twin drawers. They're a little bit wider and are going to fit your standard goods like your clothes, blankets, and what have you, outfitted with those wonderful slam latches that stay in place when that jack wagon in front of you slams on its brakes. Now, moving to the middle drawers, these are a little more unique. They are extra deep, about 36 inches to keep your hard goods that may not be able to fold or fit width-wise in these other drawers. Now, this tiny little guy right here serves a few functions. First and foremost, we can extend it to become a table for these two benches, ideal for a workspace if you need to work on your laptop, notepads, anything. You could also dine here, but mainly a workspace. And with that in mind, this little tabletop comes off. It becomes a great place to store your laptops, notebooks, pens, and all those little office type items. Beyond that, we can also use this tabletop to extend our sleeping space. Just drop it down between these two benches. And that becomes a third sleeping space for somebody you know might not want in your bed with you.
Hi.
Underneath our desk drawer, you're going to find two much larger drawers. And you may notice that these handles look a little bit different. Basically, I've replaced these slam latches with extremely heavy-duty locking latches. These were designed to hold your larger valuables, anything you want to keep in here while you're away from the van for a significant period of time. Basically, in the event of a smash and grab, while somebody might rifle through the rest of your stuff, they're not getting into this drawer. Sturdy steel construction on the lock, and then I've replaced the standard latch with a piece of maple ply that attaches it to the frame of this bed, so you're really not getting in here in any sort of quick fashion. Aside from being extremely large and locking, these are also removable. So you can actually take both of these drawers out completely, as well as the divider between them and the faux panel in the back, and you get a pass-through. So from here down, you're going to have a huge space for skis, snowboards, surfboards, kite surfing, anything you might want to bring with you on your travels that just won't fit anywhere else. There you have it, a pass-through, just in case you want to pass through. There you have it, nice, big, tall, wide pass-through for surfboards, snowboards, any of that, or as you can see, I crawled through there a bunch of times. As we climb up into the bed area, you're going to find two flare space flares on the driver and passenger side. I've insulated as well as upholstered these with a nice, robust gray tweed fabric, and you're going to notice that I say things like robust, durable a lot because I find it monumental in van building. You're going to come into contact with everything in this van on a daily basis, whether you're just kicking around, throwing stuff in and out, sleeping, everything gets touched, so I find it extremely important that everything stands the test of the time and lasts just as long as this beautiful Mercedes van. So other than that, you're going to find a couple of USB outlets here as well as on the driver's side, and then some touch LEDs that are basically there for if you're already in bed, you don't want to mess with the ceiling lights or the kitchen lights, you just want to read a little bit, that's what those are for. Other than that, we've got some nice rubber trim around the windows as well as on the entryways that I actually make from scratch. And the reason I mention that is because it's extremely annoying and I want somebody to pat me on the back for that. So So here we are at the garage portion of the van. Straight ahead, we've got that faux panel that I took off to create that pass-through space. So I'm going to show you how that works real quick. Just give it a tug. Careful not to scratch anything. And then basically these two drawers come out, as you saw, as well as the divider, and you've got this whole area for any of your larger items. Pop that back in. So other than that, you've basically got a lot of storage. Plenty up here in the middle and over here. And then in these boxes, you've got our water system. We've got a 32-gallon tank, as well as our fresh and gray water pumps and anything you need to fill that. Over here, we've got our electrical system, inverter, batteries, fuse boxes, and all that. So you'll notice there's no handles on these. It's not something you need to get into very often. So we're just gonna pop it like this, pull it off. Here you can see the back of our inverter. Our master on and off. You're going to use this if you're storing the van for a long time. If there's any emergency, just immediately turn that. Cuts power to everything. Easily accessible fuse box. Everything's labeled, amperage and all on the inside. We're just going to squeeze this back in. Nice and easy. And over here on this side, same thing. Pop it out. And there you can see our couple of pumps, the tank back there, as well as our fill hose. This is a nice little extension. It just basically stops you from having to get all the way to the tank, dripping water all over the van. Even though this is all waterproofed and everything, just makes life easy. That is that. So you will notice that our gray water tank is not in that compartment. So we've replaced the spare tire with our gray water tank. So everything's under there. It's got a nice big valve to flush the system or dump at your dumping station. If you're wondering where the spare tire went, it went on our OWL ladder tire carrier, which I'll show you right now. Sun in my eyes. I'm gonna go over here. So here we are at the back of the van. As you can see, the ladder tire carrier from OWL, which leads up to our roof deck, which we'll give you a show of right now. Look at my butt for a while. So here we are up on our roof deck. This is made of California redwood and then coated with a dyed Thompson's water seal to make it match the van, blend in a little bit better, and give it that durability we're talking about. In front of that, you'll see 280-watt solar panels, as well as our max fan just squeezed in there to give us maximum roof deck space and maximum solar. Well, that's it. Thanks for joining me on a quick walkthrough of my latest build. To get the detailed specs of this van or any other builds, as well as professional photos and some sweet Ethel gear, head over to CaliforniaCustomVans.com. Until next time.